Yeah, thank you for your introduction. This is my joint work with Razvan. And thanks for coming here in this early morning. I will start my talk. My talk is focused on DLP, which is a very fundamental problem in public key cryptography. It is a problem to solve discrete log A for a given G and G to the A, where G is a secret group of order M. And then it is very well known to solve the DLP of a general group. It takes square root of N times, which is exponential but. But however, if the DLP is defined over finite field, we can solve it in sub-exponential time. For this, we have an index calculus approach algorithm, such as number field shift and function field shift. And the complexity of DLP usually differs by the size of characteristic P, where if the DLP is defined over a small characteristic field, like a binary field or ternary field, then we have a quasi-polynomial time algorithm that is based on function field shift method. On the other hand, if DLP is defined over a larger characteristic, then most known best algorithms are based on number field shift. And in this talk, we focus on NFS, which targets larger characteristic field. Then why do we consider this problem, the DLP over finite field of large characteristic? Because it is important in pairing-based crypto. Usually a cryptographic pairing has a form that maps from two elliptical groups, which are defined over prime field, and that it maps to a finite field of extension degree n. Here we say this extension degree as embedding degree. Then the security of pairing-based crypto relies on the hardness of these two, the DLP over these two elliptical groups, and the DLP over the finite field fp to the n. So when we determine the key size of pairing-based crypto, we want discrete log over elliptical should be as hard as the DLP over finite field fp to the n. And usually, most interesting case in public pairing-based crypto occurs when the embedding degree is between 2 and 30. And we have, in particular, in the case of 128-bit security case, we have very efficient construction by Biankov, which have embedding degree 12. So I think it's important to consider this DLP over fp to the n, where n comes from the embedding degree of pairing. Let's look at brief history of NFS and FFS. NFS, to solve the DLP over prime field, was first introduced by Gordon and Shirokawa independently. And then we have a function field method to solve the DLP over binary field by Adelman. And then it has been, the NFS extended to solve DLP over P to the N when P is large by Shirokawa and JLSB. Actually, Shirokawa suggested an algorithm to use a representation of fp to the n as a ring of the algebraic integer g of I modulo p, which we call Tower number field shift. And later, JLSB suggested another approach, which is obtained by simply modifying a polynomial selection step in the NFS of prime field. In this talk, we obtain our goal by just simply combining this TNFS and JLSV, which we call that EXTNFS, extended turnover basis. Yes, so let's look at the previous state of art complexity of DAP in the finite field. It is very common in the context of NFS to use LQ notation to express the complexity. And sometimes I will just use simple this L bracket M notation, which denotes this value. So we only change here M. And this L bracket M is increasing by M. So as you can see from this table, any variant of NFS has the complexity that differs by the size of characteristic P, where we say that the characteristic P is medium compared to the total field size Q when P satisfies this relation. And then we say that P is large if it is in this case. And we say that P is in the boundary case if it is in this case. As you can see this from this table, in any case of NFS variant, the complexity of number phase shift in medium characteristic case was always larger than the complexity in the large characteristic case. And even more strangely, we had the best complexity of the NFS in medium case, in the boundary case. So, yeah. And this phenomenon was the same for any variant like multiple number phase shift or special number phase shift. You can see that any variant in so complexity of any variant in medium case was larger than the other case. So you can see from this graph easily, medium is the hardest part in the DAP. So now we can see, we can state our result. Simply speaking, we just get rid of this anomaly in the complexity of DAP. In other words, we can show that DLP in medium characteristic case is easier than DLP in large characteristic case when n, the extension degree is a composite with a factor of appropriate size. Yeah, as you can see from this table again, we can our result reduce the complexity here by combining our result. We reduce the complexity here, and this becomes less than the other part. So, by applying our EXTNFS with the JLSV algorithm, we obtain the same complexity in the medium case as large characteristic. And if we further apply our EXTNFS with the conjugation method, then the DLP, the complexity of DAP in medium case becomes less than the complexity of large characteristic case. Then, to explain our result, let's briefly review the NFS for prime field. In the NFS for prime field, we choose two polynomials which are irreducible, and they have a common root M modulo P. Then we have this commutative diagram, which is very common in NFS context. Then this commutative diagram shows that we have we can map this polynomial in integer polynomial by mapping it to modulo f and modulo p and modulo g and modulo m and modulo p. So it goes to our target field. Then with this diagram, we solve the discrete log. First, we choose the polynomial f and g as stated before. And then we sieve. In the sieving state, we collect many pairs A and B, such that the norm of A minus B alpha F and norm of A minus B alpha G are B smooth for a parameter B, where alpha F and alpha G are root of F and G. If we have such a pair AB, then they give a linear relation of disk log of small element. I say the small element means whose norm are less than B and some other. And if we get many such relations, then we can find the logarithm of a small element by solving linear algebra. And then to solve a real disk log of target element, we just express them in terms of previously computed log of small element. Yeah, I don't go detail further from here, but yeah, to extend this result to solve DLP of a non-prime field, JLSV just modified the polynomial selection part in the NFS. In JLSV, they choose F and G such that they have a common root, a common vector phi of degree n modulo p. Then now we have a similar diagram as we've seen before, but this time we target our bottom is fp to the n, which are defined by phi, a common vector of f and g. And then we also we sieve a polynomial a minus bx by taking modulo f and modulo p here, and modulo g and modulo p here, and get a relation in fp to the n. On the other hand, in TNFX, TNFS, tower number base shift, we choose f and g as same as before we did in prime case. But in this time, we choose another polynomial h, which is an irreducible polynomial of degree n, and it is also irreducible modulo p. Then we can represent our target field fp to the n as modulo as a ring of integers, a ring of algebraic integers, g of iota, and modulo p. And g of iota is a subring in a number field, which are defined by this h. Then this time we have again this diagram, but here we replace this base ring integer as a new algebraic integer, g of iota. Then we can shift a minus bx, where a and b are in g of iota, not instead of g. And then if we go through this diagram, then we get a relation here, fp to the n. This is the idea of TNFS. If you understood these diagrams well, then it's very obvious to combine this NFS, TNFS and JLSV. In TNFS, EXTNFS, we target a finite field of fp to the n, where n splits into coprime vectors. Then we would like to explain the target field fp to the n as a composition of extension field with the degree eta and kappa. And then we choose h as we did for TNFS for fp to the eta, which means h is irreducible of degree eta. And then we choose f and g as if we target the fp to the kappa, not fp to the n, using many other methods, like JLSV or conjugation and so on. Then we put k to be GCD of f and g modulo p. Then we get again this commutative diagram, which are almost the same as in the case of TNFS, but in the bottom we have this formula. So, yeah, but this time we you remember that we chose fng from integer. So k will be irreducible over fp, but we want k to be irreducible over fp to the other. So we require this GCD condition to make it automatically irreducible over fp to the other. Yeah, so then we then you can have a relation by modulo taking modulo here. Then why this simple change made a better complexity than before? Because in the complexity analysis of NFS, the size of norm plays important role. And roughly speaking, we show that the size of norm in ext-NFS for fp to the n is the same as the size of norms in classical case, classical NFS case, which we target f capital F to the kappa. So we can deal with a smaller extension degree. This means that we can we have a complexity over ext-NFS for fp to the n, which is the same as the complexity of NFS for f capital to the kappa, where capital P is a prime of size of the same size as p to the eta. So as long as capital P remains large or boundary characteristic, the cost of ext-NFS targeting fp to the n becomes the same as the cost of NFS targeting large or boundary case characteristic. So if we see example, ext-NFS with JLSV has a complexity of L of 64 instead of 96 in the case of when P is medium. And ext-NFS with conjugation have a complexity 84, L of 84 instead of L of 64. And we can apply this ext-NFS to any other variance like multiple NFS and special NFS, where special NFS we use the characteristic P which has a special form. This is mostly occurs when pairing based construction like a Biankov. In that case, we show that special ext-NFS has a complexity of L of 32 instead of L of 64 in the median case. And so we can reduce the complexity in the median case here. So I think it's better to reconsider the key size of pairing-based crypto here. Currently, we use the same recommended key size for pairing in RSA. And this key size was derived from the value L of 64. But now we have the best complexity L of 84 when P is of general form. So in that case, we should increase the key size by 1.3 about. And in the case of when characteristic P is of special form, then previous best complexity was by Zhu and Piero, which was L of 32 when P is large and L of 64 when P is medium. But Biankov with in the case of Biankov, which has an embedding degree 12, I think that it seems to be considered as medium prime case because currently used key size derived from the formula 64. But now our special ext-NFS has a complexity of L of 32 in either case. So maybe it's better to increase the key size by twice. But Yeah, but please don't panic, because this is not a precise estimation, because there is a hidden constant in AQ notation, and it will take some time to derive more precise one, because we need some optimized implementation widget. But please don't panic again, either, if there comes new record. So, yeah, you can change your key size, or you don't, as you wish, but I'm not sure. So, yeah, so actually we didn't implement our widget to solve the DLP, but we have a graph for the size of norms, which is a main factor that indicates the complexity. Here you can see that EX10FS with conjugation method seems to be the best choice in the range of this size of field when you target FP2D6. And here, if you want to target FP2D12, which is an interesting case in the Bean curve, and when P is of special form, then it seems that special EX10FS becomes the best choice as the field size grows. So, yeah. And I'd like to before conclude this talk, I'd like to announce some recent development on this work, which applies to embedding degree N that splits into non-coprime vectors. First, Saka and Singh showed that when N is power of 2, then we have a complexity of L of 64. But soon after this work, Zhang and me showed that when N is composite, any composite, then we have the same best complexity as we had in EX10FS. The idea is simply just choose F and G from G of I instead of G. So we have this graph for any composite N with the appropriate eight sides of vector. Yeah, then let's conclude with some remark. I think we should reconsider of the key size of pairing-based crypto. But our algorithm does not apply for prime field or prime extension degree field. So Chatterjee et al. Recently suggested to use pairing with embedding degree 1, but I'm not sure about the efficiency of them. So maybe it would be an interesting work to improve the pairing computation with embedding degree 1 or prime. And on the other hand, it would be an interesting question to improve NFS for prime field or prime extension degree field. Okay, thank you for your attention.